is not just about numbers and equations, and it's not just about getting the right answer. Math is about spotting patterns and finding similarities between different situations so that we can understand more stuff better. Music is not just about pitch and sound. It's about how those sounds relate to each other to make us feel things. We can use math to understand what's going on inside the music that is making us feel those things. Math works by abstraction, which means that we forget certain details around a situation in order to understand what's going on at its heart and making it work. We can perform abstraction in music in all sorts of different ways. We can forget about pitch in order to get rhythm. Or we could forget about rhythm and just think about melody. Here's one of my favorite abstractions from a piece of music. Like many pieces of Bach, this piece is written in what's called polyphony, which means that there are several lines of music that wind their way around each other. And in theory, you could take each line by itself and see how it goes. When you study a piece in polyphony, you often play each line by itself to understand how the lines fit together. When I first studied this piece of music, I got really confused by it. So I decided to draw a picture. This is a very extreme abstraction of the piece of music, where I've forgotten almost everything about it, except where each line of music is in relation to the others at any given moment. The thing is that these lines of music sometimes cross over each other, and then they don't come back again. I could see that the red bass line ends up as an alto, and the blue tenor line has to end up as a soprano, and the green alto ends up as a bass, and the black line, the soprano, has to end up as a tenor. This picture is actually a piece of math, even though when I drew it, I didn't think I was doing math. Sometimes you're doing math even when you don't realize it. Mathematicians study this kind of picture as a braid, and we study things like how the lines cross over each other. What happens if we turn it round and look at it a different way? What happens if we wave it around? Can strands move? The thing is that you don't have to know that this picture is there in order to listen to the piece of music and enjoy it. That's the same with math. You don't have to know what math is all around us in order to go about your daily life. If you do understand the math that's around us, then maybe we'll be able to do everything better, understand things better, fix things when they go wrong. That's really the point about math. It's not just about getting answers to things. It's about finding clarity by understanding them better.